Hi, I'm Grant from Blackmagic Design, and I wanted to do a quick video update on ATEM switchers. So as you might know, we've got a family of switchers called ATEM Mini. They're great little switchers, and they're very affordable, but they're very, very powerful. Now, they're based on HDMI connections, but now we have a new family of switchers based on ATEM Mini, and they're called ATEM SDI. They have 3G SDI connections. So while they're similar to ATEM Mini, they actually have double the number of video outputs. Now, there's three models in the family, as you can see here. Now, the entry-level model is called ATEM SDI. It's similar to ATEM Mini, but it has four 3G SDI inputs, so it works up to four cameras. It also has two separate 3G SDI outputs. And like ATEM Mini, they work in 720p and 1080 HD formats. And all the SDI inputs have resync, plus up, down, and cross conversion on them. The USB is a webcam output in full 1080 HD. And the USB you'll plug into a computer, so it just looks like a webcam. So you can use any streaming software that works with webcam. With a webcam will work fine. You know, it also has two 3.5mm audio jacks for microphones. It's got Ethernet on it for remote control. It's got a screw-in power connector that includes a power supply with it that comes with it. Now, as far as creative features go, it's got a built-in DVE. You've got full set of transitions, cut, mix, wipe, dip to color. It even has DVE transitions. You know, it's enough transitions to be really creative. Plus, it has a built-in ATEM advanced chroma key as well. Now, you can do a lot from the front panel, but the hidden power is in by using the ATEM software control. The ATEM software control is included for free, and it works on Mac and Windows. And it's the same software used on the really big ATEM switchers. So you can connect with the Ethernet or USB. But USB is nice because you don't need to change any settings in the switcher. You just plug your computer into the USB socket, and the software will just work. Now, the software allows full control of the switcher. There's palettes for all the switcher functions, like color generators, keyers, transitions, things like that. Now, if we change the camera control tab, you see the software's got a bunch of tabs in it. Now, the camera control tab allows control of the cameras, the controls sent to the cameras via the SDI, and also the tele information sent to the camera via SDI as well for lighting up the tele light. Now, with the control, you can adjust iris, focus, color tint, black level, and more. Yeah, the color tints actually change using the color wheels. And on the media page, there's a media page. This is where the graphics are loaded. Graphics support alpha channels, and the media pool can store up to 20 graphics. And then you can select them into the media player, and then the switcher can see them and use them for, you know, like a graphic for keying. And that's perfect for titles that sort of blend over the background image. Now, on the audio page, this allows full control of the built-in Fairlight audio mixer. The audio level control is on the front panel, but the software, using the software, is better. And you control also, there's a 6-band parametric EQ built in, and you can control it from there. Plus, you can also control the audio compressor, the expander, and the limiter. The EQ and dynamics status is shown on the top of the channel indicators there. Really easy to use, and every input has EQ and dynamics. Now, there's a whole bunch of other features in the switcher. It's got macros. It's got hyperdeck control. You can control hyperdecks. It's got XML exports for the switcher state, so you can save the switcher state. And also, the startup state can be saved as well. So when it powers on, it'll come up in a known state, which is different to exporting the state. It supports multiple languages, and there's also a developer SDK. So ATEM SDI is available now. It'll be priced at $345. It's an amazing and super compact design. You know, it's really a miniaturized broadcast quality live production switcher, and it's not a dumbed down design like the low-end switches I had to use when I was a kid. You know, there's an amazing set of features built in. You know, features like standards conversion on all the inputs. It's got the ATEM advanced chroma key. It's got the Fairlight audio mixer, it's got the built-in DVE, it's got a media pool to store the graphics and titles, a downstream key, and, you know, and a lot more. So that's the entry-level model. So now let's talk about the mid-range model. Now, this model is similar to ATEM Mini Pro ISO, but it's called ATEM SDI Pro ISO. Now, this model has a hardware streaming engine built in, so there's no extra streaming software required. It uses the Ethernet to stream, but you can also plug in a smartphone into the USB and use mobile data. Now, the settings for the stream are loaded in using the streaming palette and the ATEM software control. But you can also turn on the stream using the front panel, which I could do. There it is there. It's great having the streaming built in. But with a streaming engine built in, you can also record it. So this lets you record to a USB disk. Now, it's an exact duplicate of the video you're streaming. Now, the video is encoded into H.264 format with the AAC audio codec. And that's the format you need to upload the files direct to YouTube or video sites. I'll start recording. There we are there. And you can connect to multiple disks using a USB hub, so it works with more than one disk. Now, the settings for recording are also in the ATEM software control. Now, ATEM SDI Pro ISO has a built-in timecode generator, and that's encoded into the SDI outputs. So the disk recordings will also use that timecode generator. And if you're not using the USB for recording, it still works as a webcam, so that's nice too. Now, this is an ISO model, so it also supports the ISO recording feature. That means you can record all four SDI inputs to a disk at the same time, plus the program feed. So that's five streams in total it can record. That means you can re-edit the video later using multicam features in most edit software. And all the video files have matching time code, and the video inputs are converted and resynced, so they all line up perfectly for multicam editing. But we also record a DaVinci Resolve project file. So your switcher actions actually become an edit timeline in DaVinci. So it's an amazing feature, and you know, I use it all the time. And in fact, I use the sync bin in the cut page because it's really fast. It's much faster to edit multicam in the sync bin. Plus, we also record the audio into a separate folder, and the audio is clean from all the inputs, so you can use like DaVinci or audio software to remix all the audio later as well. Now, the last big feature in ATEM SDI Pro is it has a multi-view for the video output. This allows you to monitor all the video sources plus program and preview on a single monitor. You can turn the audio meters and custom labels on. Plus, there's also a view of your media player, so you can see what graphics loaded. And there's also status. There's streaming status and recording and audio mixer status on there as well. You know, when you've got thousands of people watching a live event, you really don't want to, you want to know the stream's okay, so it's pretty important to have that. We think having this multi-view built in is really useful. Now, the ATEM SDI Pro ISO is available now. It'll be priced at $795. I think it's a really nice step up from the entry-level model. It's, you know, really nice having the streaming and recording built in, as you don't need any extra gear hanging off. It also makes it kind of the most portable model when you think about it. And the multi-view is also fantastic to have. You only need a single monitor to view all your cameras and status. Okay, so now for the top model. Now, this is the biggest one. It's called ATEM SDI Extreme ISO. The big change is it's got 8 3G SDI inputs. It also has 4 independent 3G SDI outputs, so it's much bigger. It's really double the size. It has a much larger front panel with select bus and camera control. It also has a headphone socket for monitoring. Now, what's one of the unique features is it's got a really powerful multi-view. You can change the number of views between 16, 13, 10, 7, and 4 views at the same time. Plus, each view can actually have its input changed. So you can select the video inputs or other internal sources, like such as media players or streaming status, and you can sort of change which view they're on as well, so you can rearrange it all. With more inputs, the failed audio mix is obviously a lot bigger. It has to handle all the extra inputs, but all the inputs still include effects such as EQ, compressor, limiter, and expander. Now, another big thing is it's got 4 ATEM advanced chroma keys in this model, which is great for virtual sets, and it now has 2 downstream keys as well, which is great for graphics overlays. But it also has 2 DBEs. So on top of the 2 DBEs built in, is it also has SuperSource. Now, this is actually pretty amazing. The SuperSource is a multi-layer processor with 4 extra DBEs. So you can build a composition, and it sort of shows up into the switcher as one of the video inputs into the main switcher. It's like an internal input, and allows you to have 4 DBEs layered with a background. Now, it's really useful for interviews with multiple people. You can position all the DBEs for each person, and then you can put a graphic over the top of it to create kind of like nice borders and a really nice composition. It's extremely powerful. Now, this is an ISO model, so it has recording on all the inputs, but now it'll record 8 inputs. Now, it records them all to separate files with matching time code plus the program file. So now we have a total of 9 streams at the same time being recorded. It also records all the raw audio from the 8 inputs, so you can do the audio mixing later. And it records the DaVinci Resolve project file as well, so it's very powerful. In fact, you could just use it as an 8-channel ISO recorder if you wanted to. It's an extremely powerful switcher. Now, the ATEM SDI Extreme ISO is available now as well. It'll be priced at $1,495. You know, it's a real monster of a switcher. It's a really great high-end model. It's got 8 inputs and 4 outputs. It's very flexible. The multi-view allows up to 16 views. There's more advanced chroma keys in this one. Plus, it has the streaming all built in, of course, as well. Now, these SDI models are great because they can be expanded. They work with a whole range of SDI equipment. And if you look over to the side over here, you can see we've actually set up a studio. It's a typical example of a small studio. But we've connected a range of our equipment. And these are the kinds of products you can add to ATEM SDI, you know, if you want to expand your own facility. Now, we have an ATEM 1ME advanced panel here. It's a great, really powerful way to control the switcher, a good alternative to the front. It has a T-bar control, a whole bunch of on-screen menus, you can see there. It's got separate buttons for all the keys, and it's got a joystick even for adjusting the DVE position. Next to that, we have a ATEM camera control panel. Now, this gives you broadcast standard camera control. It works very much like the industry standard camera controls. Now, all of the camera data is actually sent via the SDI outputs of the switcher, this is the switcher here, back to the cameras. And they plug into the camera's program return feed SDI input, and it gives the camera operator a view of what the switch is doing. But we also send the camera control information back to the cameras with that. Plus, we also light up the tally lights with that, all in the SDI output. Now, when you're using the panel, it's best to set one of the SDI outputs for monitoring. There's 4 outputs on the switcher, obviously. So when the knobs are pushed, it'll actually use that output to switch the monitoring between different cameras, and then you can see what you're doing. I'll show you how that works over here. So there's the cameras there. And if I push the buttons on the knobs, if I push on the knobs, you can see it switches that particular output that's been assigned for monitoring to the monitor. And then you can see what the camera adjusting. So I've pushed this one and I can adjust the camera. See. And rotating the ring on the bottom of the knob adjusts the black level. This is actually the Iris. So there's other controls as well. You can set the camera gain on the front panel. There's color tint controls on there. You can even set the camera focus on the panel. Now you can control up to four cameras at the same time, but changing the camera numbers is easy. So you can control more than four cameras because you can reassign them. Now over on the studio over here, if you can get a shot of that, we've got Blackmagic Studio cameras on set here. These are Blackmagic Studio Camera 4K Pro models. They're all connected under the control of the switcher, which is the switcher over there. Now the tally lights are being controlled by the switcher. Plus we have three microphones plugged into the cameras. Now each camera has stereo balanced XLR audio inputs. Plus the performance of those audio inputs on the cameras is really, really good. Very, very low noise. But the real trick is actually the Fairlight audio mixer in the ATEM SDI Extreme. It can separate out the stereo channels into two separate mono channels. So if we could just trigger over to the Fairlight page, you can see it over there. And you can see that the first two stereo inputs have been separated into four independent audio channels. And this means you can add audio treatments to them independently because each microphone is a separate input to the audio mixer. And so you can put a separate EQ limiting compression on each microphone and do separate treatment on all of them. So with two cameras here, that actually gives us four independent microphone inputs across those two cameras. It also means you don't need a separate audio mixer for this kind of workflow. You can just plug the microphones into the cameras and then mix it all in the switcher. So it's a really nice setup, and it really just shows you how you can expand this whole workflow as you grow. I even have a HyperDeck Studio Mini, HD Mini over there as a master recorder. And that's great because it allows recordings in formats the switcher doesn't do internally, so like DNX or ProRes, or even in H.264 in lower compression than the quality setting in the switcher. So that's the advantage of the switcher having SDI connections. There's lots of professional products you can plug in to grow your studio. Now, then later on, of course, if you outgrow ATEM SDI, then you can replace it with like an ATEM Constellation HD. Yeah, we've got models of ATEM Constellation HD with 10, 20, and 40 inputs. And those models actually have 6, 12, and 24 independent outputs. So these switches can get really big. With SDI, you're never really trapped in a low-end workflow. All this equipment is used by high-end broadcasters every day. And you can mix and match different equipment as you expand and really change and reconfigure your setup. So before I finish up, I wanted to explain some of the differences between ATEM SDI and the ATEM Constellation HD switches. You know, we only really introduced the ATEM Constellation HD switches a few months ago, so they're still really new. But there are some differences I wanted to explain. The big advantage to ATEM SDI is that they're self-contained. You know, they have the recording and streaming built in, so they're more portable. But they have less inputs and outputs. Well, you know, while on ATEM Constellation HD switches, they're bigger with more inputs and outputs. But they don't have the streaming and recording built in. But they do have webcam, actually. The Constellation HD switches actually have a webcam. So with ATEM Constellation HD switches, all the cost really goes into making a bigger switcher. Whereas with ATEM SDI, some of that cost goes into the streaming and the recording electronics. So the switcher itself isn't as big. And it really explains kind of the main difference between the two ATEM switcher families. Now, there's also one other difference. The ATEM SDI does not have Intel ASE 1080i television standards built into it. The ATEM SDI will accept 1080i standards on its inputs, but they'll be converted to the switcher standard, which is normally 1080p. There's really no 1080i output because ATEM SDI is really designed for delivering online content, and interlaced video is horrible for that. Even modern television stations really hate interlaced video. Like modern televisions, they're all flat screens. They hate interlaced video. I really don't know anyone that still watches television on a vacuum tube. But the ATEM Constellation HD switches are designed for broadcasters, so they do include all the 1080i standards. So ATEM SDI will allow a 1080i source, SDI source, to be connected to its input, but it'll just convert it to the output format. Just one output, the 1080i. So if you're a broadcaster working in 1080i, then you probably want to use ATEM Constellation HD switches. That'd be the best choice. A lot of broadcasters, though, do work in 1080p now because they're delivering online content. And all our cameras and HyperDecks and everything all switch between interlaced progressive standards anyway, so it doesn't really matter from that point of view. You can just switch them in the menu. So that's really the main differences. That's really the between the two families. And the other, you know, obviously the difference is ATEM Constellation HD switches are much bigger. You know, the top model has 40 inputs. It's got two super source processors, four DVEs, which is 12 DVEs in total. It's got 16 advanced chroma keyers, four downstream keyers. So there's lots of room to grow your studio if you adopted a Constellation HD. Anyway, so look, we hope you like these new ATEM SDI switches. That's all we have for this video. So take care and thanks for watching the update. Bye.